Hey guys, today I want to talk about curses. Am I cursed? I've been single 5 years. Is it because of a curse? I've spoken to many Christians about this, even leaders in the church, pastors, counselors, and I can say that 1 out of 2 of those people would say that I am cursed, or that I have evil spirit preventing me from achieving my purpose that God has for me. Or, you know, there are some evil forces around me in my home that are preventing me from receiving the blessings of God. I've received many, many messages that are like that, and then other messages that, no, you're not cursed, you've been redeemed, you've been saved, you've been this, you've been that. It's just SOL, shit out of luck, basically, or the timing of being in this world at this time when there's like everything is so messed up in this world. You know, I get all sorts of things. So, but I want to focus on the cursed. The Bible says the enemy can only affect us if we give him permission. And, you know, through sin, that's how we give him permission. And of course, I'm not perfect. Of course, I'm a sinner. I've sinned many times. And usually that can open a door for the enemy to come in and rob me of my blessings, or affect me in my moods, or any way that he sees fit, he will come in and, you know, shoot his fiery arrows at me. But in the same way, those sins I repent from, because those sins does not come from a willing heart. I do not want to sin. I don't want to do these things, yet sometimes I do, and then I see that, and then I repent. So therefore I believe God looks at the heart, and my heart is in a good place. It's willingly wanting to not sin. It's willingly repenting. I am seeking the righteousness of God on a daily basis. So when I sin, I don't believe that the enemy can destroy my life in this way so deeply by cursing me, by, you know, putting a huge block, I guess you could say, on that prevents me from meeting my husband. I don't believe that at all, because my heart is right and it's aligned with God, even though I'm a human and I fail short on a daily basis. So in that aspect, I don't believe I'm opening doors for the enemy to come in and curse me that much or that bad. You know, he can make me sad, he can make me lose control with the food that I eat, because let's be honest, I've gained a lot of weight in the last, I'd say, year. But in this isolation, I just want to eat. But that's what I believe the enemy can get a hold, is on the surface level, because of that, because of where I am in my Christian walk. So in that aspect of curse, I don't believe I'm cursed because of the sins that I occasionally do. Now, I've had other Christians that would tell me, well, you need to get rid of everything in your home that are cursed, that you have sinned with, or using to sin, or anything that has symbols on it, or occult symbols. Even to the point where someone told me I have to get rid of my mattress if I've done the deed on it. Or I have to get rid of the clothes that I was wearing during the time I was sinning. Or I have to get rid of gifts from exes. Or I have to get rid of anything that would, you know, resemble an occult symbol in jewelry, in clothes, in many things. So I've had Christians go really deep like that. And again, I don't believe that it's that deep. I don't believe God would allow that much depth to prevent someone from, you know, being blessed, from receiving his blessings. So I want to read two scriptures that basically confirm to me that I am not cursed. One is 1 John 4:4. You, dear children, are from God and have overcome them, because the one who is in you is greater than the one who is in the world. That to me tells me a lot. You know, I have the Holy Spirit in me. So what does the enemy have against me? Nothing. Another one is John 8:36. So if the Son sets you free, you are truly free. You are free indeed. You gotta take scripture at face value. It says I'm free. So then I am free. Those things, those clothes, mattress, or whatever, I'm not bound to those things. I am free. I've been set free. You know, I am a child of God now, and the enemy doesn't hold anything against me unless I willingly sin and do not repent from the sin. Then the enemy can have a foothold on my life, but I don't do that. In the last 2 years, I have not allowed the enemy to come in and take a foothold in my life. Maybe in the past I've willingly sinned. I've justified my sins. I was just not, you know, aligned with God. But now that I am, I'm able to say, no, I'm not cursed. I'm not. Maybe back then I was, but now I know the name of Jesus is enough to kick the enemy out of my house. And I just have to say it once. I have to take authority, and I have to command the enemy to leave. And guess what? He has no choice to leave. The name of Jesus is enough to say once, just one time, to cast out the enemy, and he's out. So, no, I'm not cursed. What am I? I don't know. Maybe they were right that it's just the timing. This world we're in right now is completely messed up. So, you know, being single during this time is a little... But I have to give credit to God that anything is possible through Christ. Anything. Through any season, through any times. Doesn't matter how bad the world is, God can move. So why isn't he not moving? I don't know. But I know that it's not because I'm cursed. And I don't know. But I do know that I am patient. And for the first time in my life in the last 2 years, I've been patient. This is like just saying it. Is like unbelievable. I've been that person where I can't be single and I had to jump from one boyfriend to another. So the fact that I've been single for 5 years, but in the last 2 years I'm patient? Yeah. The glory belongs to the Lord, 100%. I don't know, tell me what you think about that, about being cursed, about being single for so long and not comprehending or understanding why. I don't know if you've dug into how the enemy works or the occult or the curses or anything of that, because I've dabbled in that in the past. I've tried to dig deep into the occult just to understand the enemy and how he functions. And so that will be a video for another time, because that's really insane and intense and deep. But I will talk about the enemy. Okay, my work is calling me. As you can tell, all these noises, so I gotta go back to work. But I will make another video on that subject in the future. So thanks for listening, and let me know what you think about curses. Bye.